Hey guys, this is Xamarin guy. So in this tutorial we are going to make list page item selected event. Just like if you select this first item in the given list view, then we should navigate to next page with id 1, and then if you select on second item, then it should go to next page of id 2, and then this is my third page that is going to be displayed when I select that third list item. So let's create such type of project. As we have already discussed about creating list view using MBBM approach in our previous tutorial, I request you to go through that. And then here inside our code behind of app.xaml, here I am setting my list page as our main page and giving it as a navigation page, because we are going to navigate our list items towards next page. And then my list page is being created inside our views folder. This is my content page that I am creating it inside our views folder. Here we'll create a simple list view giving its item source as binding my list collector. That is, it will collect all the details as well as text from the given view model. It will act like a receiver which will receive all its data from the given view model through my list collector. So let's tell our view that we are going to get all its data from the given view model folder where I have created my new page as my list page view model. This is my source which is going to deliver all its data towards my views, that is binding food detail as well as food name. So for that view model, we need to get all the food name as well as food details inside our model folder so that our view model will know that my list collector will be our variable and which will collect all its properties from my list model using getter as well as setter, and then my list collector will give all its data content towards the given views. So we are going to make an observable collection for our my list collector which will get all its properties from my list model and set its properties values such as id, food name as well as food detail. That is, it will get all its property from here and set its value inside our given view model, and view model will act as our source which will deliver all its content towards the given page using my list collector. So let's run our project. This is my simple list view. Now our next objective is to create a simple tap event inside our given list view. So let's type item tab and then create a handler inside our code behind of my list page.xaml.cs. So I'll cut that. So our navigation to work on, we are going to create it as asynchronous task as we are going to let it work on background thread. Whenever our items is tapped inside our list page, then this item tab event argument will take that item id from the given properties that is defined inside our list model and then set it to given variable as my selected item. Our work is over. This variable my selected item will contain the id, and then using switch case we are going to navigate to the respected page. So let's create a case 1 where I'll navigate that id 1 towards the given destination page as await navigation push asynchronous to given new page. So let's create a new page for that. Inside our views folder we are going to create a new content page and where we are going to navigate to a given new page. So let's give its name as my page 1 and then create a new page, and then let's create another page for instance so that we can navigate our second page id towards this my page 2. So let's decorate this page placing a simple label text inside the given stack layout. So I'll place a simple label text and then give it name as this is my first page and then with id 1, anything you may like, and then close that label giving a text color as red, and then we'll copy same code inside our second page. You can do whatever you may like. Here I'll give its label name as 2 with id 2, and then I'll change that color name so that it gets navigate to our second page. Now here I'll create another case. Before that let's create navigation for the given first page, and then for the given case 2 we'll navigate to our second page. Here we should use break condition. This is my page 2, so that this is my exception that has occurred because of that break condition. Okay, this is the simple statement that will tell whenever the item gets selected, then navigate to next page and then unselect that given list page item selected. Now let's build and run our project whether it gives us correct output or not. So whenever first item in the given list is selected, then it should navigate to first page, and then second list item, then it should navigate to second page. That's all. Thank you guys. Thanks for watching. Keep in touch for next tutorials.